Do not search for support phone numbers. Hi, everyone. Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's one of the more consistent stories that I hear about often. It goes like this. Someone's having a problem with some random service. They call the some random service support number. They end up being charged a bunch of money. The problem is still not resolved. The issue, of course, is that the person didn't really talk to anyone at some random service. They fell victim to a scam, and it's an easy one to fall into. Fortunately, it's also easy to avoid. Now, to be clear, throughout this video, I'm going to be talking about some random service. Pretend it's a company name, and indeed, there's a domain name that I'll be referring to, somerandomservice.com. These are all just examples. If you use a search engine, Google or any of the others, to search for a support phone number, there is a very high risk that what you find will be a scammer's phone number instead. Particularly when the service in question doesn't have an actual phone number to call, scammers are more than happy to try and intercept you with your desire that there be a phone number to call. There are a couple of ways this happens. Spammers can buy ads, and they can abuse the SEO system. Google, as we know, is driven by advertising. Other search engines may also be to varying degrees. Anyone can purchase ads that appear in search results. If they're willing to pay enough, those ads can even appear above the normal, also known as organic, search results. So if you search for some random service customer support number, you might get results such as an ad titled some random service customer support with a phone number owned by a scammer. An ad titled get help with some random service, call our customer support with a phone number, again, owned by a scammer. An actual search result for some random service pointing to the some random service website and, if there is one, listing the real some random service support phone number. And of course, actual additional search results that probably relate somehow to some random service's customer support, but may or may not include the actual some random service website. Right next to the first two results, those ads, there's usually an icon that is very easy to miss. It's a small ad symbol. The symbol is typically very tiny, not much bigger than a single character. Many people don't notice it, and they mistake the advertisement for a legitimate organic search result. They call the number listed there, not knowing that it's a scammer, not the real service. Scammers also game SEO. Now, website owners, such as myself, want to appear at the top of the search results so that you're more likely to click and visit their website. SEO, or search engine optimization, is a collection of techniques website owners use to try and make that happen. For example, I can create information both off-page that you don't see and on-page that you do, or I can structure what I've written to optimize this page for the phrase, search for support phone. My hope is that someone searching for that phrase will find a link to this page high in the search results and choose to visit. Scammers do this too. In fact, they abuse SEO techniques to achieve the result. For example, one of the other ways that SEO determines whether or not a web page is authoritative on a topic is how many pages link to that web page. So if a web page on a site that isn't askleo.com has a link to this page with the text search for support phone, Google sees that as a sign that this page relates to the phrase search for support phone. Scammers abuse this by using compromised sites and comment spam to create thousands of those links around the web, hoping that Google will assume that the page is a very important source for that particular phrase and thus should be ranked more highly. Now, let's assume the scammers have done their dirty work for this search. Now, if you search for some random service customer support number, you might get search results such as, any ads that you see at the top are probably benign and loosely related to what you've searched for. Since these are typically legitimate ads, they're usually not trying to fool you. You may then get one or more official-looking actual search results relating to some random service customer support phone, but linking to a scammer's website. The scammer has successfully fooled Google into thinking that these pages are legitimate sources of information. You may then get one or more search results pointing to official pages from some random service about their customer support phone. These rank lower than the scammer because the scammer fooled the algorithm that determines which pages are the most legitimate source of information. And then, of course, more additional actual search results that probably relate to some random service customer support, but may or may not include the some random service website. And, of course, scammers will do both of these things. They will buy ads and they will game SEO at the same time. When both techniques are in play, things get worse. If you search for some random service customer support number, you might get results such as an ad titled Some Random Service Customer Support with a Scammer's Phone Number. Another ad entitled Get Help with Some Random Service Call Our Customer Support with a Phone Number, again owned by a scammer. You might then get one or more official-looking actual search results relating to some random service customer support phone that link to the scammer's site. Again, the scammer successfully fooled Google into thinking that these pages were the important pages for that topic. You'll then get, probably, one or more search results pointing to the actual official pages from some random service about their customer support phone and other offerings. These rank lower than the scammer because the scammer fooled the algorithm. And they're lower than the ads because the scammer paid enough money to make sure that the ads were up on top. And of course, you'll then be followed by actual search results that probably relate to some random service's customer support, but may or may not include the some random service website. As you can see, it's a misleading and confusing mess. The bottom line is that you cannot trust search results unless you're very, very observant and you know what to look for. Given everything we've just learned about how scammers poison search results, it's clear it's just not safe to search for contact information like this. Instead, go to the website directly. In my fictitious Some Random Service example, I would type in somerandomservice.com to visit the website and then look for contact information directly on that website. Not in any search results, but on the actual somerandomservice.com website. That way, you know you're getting the information directly from the source. And remember, there may not be a phone number. Not all services have numbers you call. That doesn't mean you should go searching. It means there's no number to call. Now, I know that people will search anyway. There's a really odd side effect of the way many people go to websites. Instead of typing in, say, askleo.com, many people type askleo into their favorite search engine and then just click on whatever the first result happens to be. This is one of the reasons that terms like Facebook and Outlook and Hotmail are some of the most searched for terms. People aren't really searching, they're just using search as a way to get there from here. Now, those results can also be poisoned by scammers too, but it's not common. If you use this technique, and it's an easy habit to get into, I'll admit, then make sure you have landed where you intend to go. If you expect to visit Ask Leo, make sure that it's askleo.com that appears in the browser address bar. Bottom line, avoid using search when looking for specific contact information like phone numbers. Instead, visit the website of the company you're dealing with and get the information there. If you do use a search engine, be sure to be extra cautious. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/177623. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.